Welcome to NexiGo. My name's Savanna, and for today's video, we're going to show you all the tips and tricks for our newest webcam, the Iris, and how to use its remote. From its features to troubleshooting issues, we're here to help. Let's get started.
The new Iris remote has been uniquely designed to include all of its features so you can switch to each mode seamlessly. Press to flip through the Iris's three preset image modes: streaming mode, low light mode, and meeting mode. If you need to make any changes in one of the modes, the Iris's flash memory will retain the settings for the next time. The auto framing and auto tracking button are the same. To turn on auto framing, press the button once, then press again to turn off. To turn on the auto tracking feature, press and hold the same button. To turn it off, press and hold it again. This mode will reframe the image to fit everyone in its field of view. It is ideal for helping to set up conference or group shots. While auto framing is active, you can also zoom in and out using the zoom buttons, or set a preset for any of the frames that the AI creates. This button can serve two different functions. The first is creating framing presets. With auto framing and auto tracking off, adjust the zoom, pan, and tilt to your desired position. Then press the preset button once to enter preset settings mode, and press one of the numbered buttons to set the preset to that number. Presets can be used for numbers 0 through 9. To recall a preset, simply press its corresponding number.
It's important to note that presets will not save your light or color settings, only pan, tilt, and zoom.
When auto framing or tracking are enabled, press the preset button to change the AI sensitivity to low, medium, or high.
The numbered buttons can be used to set and recall the preset position, or they can be used for remote control or camera address for multicam setups.
Multicam setups can be very helpful for podcasts where you want to switch your cameras between two people, or if you need several angles for a piano performance, for example. To set the camera's address to channel 1, press the following sequence of buttons: star, pound, then 1. Then follow the same sequence for the other cameras, but replace the last number with 2, 3, or 4 to set each camera to those channels. Press and hold one of the numbered buttons for 4 seconds. 7, 8, 9, or 0 to change to a new channel. The red indicator light will start flashing rapidly. When the flashing slows, it has changed channels.
The remote can now control the camera of the corresponding frequency.
The number 7 corresponds to number 1, 8 to number 2, 9 to number 3, and 0 to number 4.
For more information, check out the Iris features video from the link in the description below.
The picture-in-picture and facial enhancement feature are the same button. Press this button to turn the PIP mode on, then press it again to turn it off. The picture-in-picture mode will have the small frame automatically track or frame you, and you can adjust the large frame as desired. Please note that any changes to exposure or color settings will apply to both images. Press and hold to turn the facial enhancement feature on, then press and hold to turn it off. Press the video format button to cycle through the HDMI video resolutions. Please note that this only applies when you have the HDMI plugged into a capture card. Otherwise, you can change video resolution like normal in your software settings. If you would like to record at 4K 30fps, make sure to connect an HDMI cord to your Iris webcam and use a capture card for ideal uncompressed video. Press the red power button to turn the camera on or off. A red indicator light will flash each time you press a button. If you don't see a light, check the batteries and try again. To use the zoom function, press the zoom plus and minus buttons. Once you zoom in, use the arrow buttons to pan and tilt the camera's view to frame it to your liking. The Iris can zoom up to 5 times by default. You can increase this to 10 times in the OSD menu. Press the menu button once to open or close the on-screen display, or OSD menu. use the arrow buttons to navigate the menu, the home button to select options, and the menu button to go back to the previous menu. While the OSD menu is open, pressing the menu button once will return you to the previous screen. If you press and hold for at least 2 seconds, it will mirror or unmirror the OSD menu horizontally. The best thing about having the menu is so that you can easily adjust settings like brightness, saturation, exposure, and more. Press the home button to turn the camera's information menu on, then press again to turn it off. Press to mute or unmute the webcam's microphone. Press to turn on backlight compensation, then press again to turn it off. What are the best times to use AI tracking versus framing? AI tracking is preferable when one person is giving a lecture or presentation, while framing is for including multiple people in one shot during a larger meeting or a conference call. How is the quality of this webcam's microphone and video?
The dual microphones on the Iris are optimized to handle both small conferences and home use. To demonstrate this, here is a recording of the Iris's microphones as compared to some of our competitors.
Hi everyone, this is a recording of the NexiGo Iris.
When would I need a capture card for the Iris?
For video calls, a capture card is unnecessary.
Since the Iris uses a standard USB 3.0 connector, it can still function as a 4K plug-and-play webcam without needing a capture card. If you want the highest quality uncompressed video for recording, say, for YouTube or Twitch, the HDMI cord and capture card can provide you with uncompressed 4K video quality. That way, your videos have the highest resolution with bright colors, contrast, and sharpness. Can other people see my OSD menu on a video call? Yes, they can see it all. We would recommend that you have all your settings just right before you start a video call.
What is the facial enhancement feature?
The facial enhancement setting improves qualities like exposure, contrast, or saturation if the customer doesn't have sufficient lighting. It only works for customers if they feel the image is underexposed or pale.
If you've performed these tests and are still finding problems with your webcam or remote, NexiGo is happy to replace any defective part.
Simply email us at cs@nexigo.com and Tina will get you sorted right away.